Your barbecue should be in good working order. Your barbecue should be on a flat, even surface. You should keep it well away from trees, overhanging shrubs, sheds, etc. Please ensure your children and your pets and your little loved ones keep as far away as possible from said area. Playing with balls, etc. is not a good idea. Also, I'd like you to make sure that you never leave said barbecue unattended. Need to make sure someone's keeping an eye on it at all times. Wise idea is to keep a bucket of water, maybe some sand to hand if you possibly can, should it get out of control. And towards the end of your cooking extravaganza, please don't try and get rid of it straight away, mate. Let it cool down, make sure it's safe to do so. And when you're getting rid of the coals, ensure that they're in a metal container rather than a plastic container.
Anyone who comes across a water incident or is involved, dial 999 straight away, because it's really important to get the emergency services on the road. And don't attempt to go in the water yourself, because the chances are you'll get caught up and we'll have two people to rescue rather than one. When people think that they can swim really confidently in a swimming pool, they might often think that they'll be fine to go and swim in open water, such as a lake or a canal or a river, but there's lots of hidden dangers that people don't see or is not visible from the surface. Even if there's something in the water, there could be debris underneath, there could be diseases in the water that's not visible. And also a big one for us is cold water shock. Even in May, June, July, when you have these really hot days, you might think it's a good idea to cool off in a lake or a local open water source, and the water can be a lot more cold than you realise, and your body suddenly starts going into shock. And we always encourage people not to swim alone, so if they were to enter the water, there's someone else with them on the bank side, so they always know that they're in the water and they're not ever left alone. Also knowing your location, exactly where you are, because the emergency services gaining access to you is really vital. For a location in Hertfordshire such as Lee Valley, it's so vast and there's so many entry points, the emergency services will find it hard to locate you if you don't know where you are.
I'd like to tell you about a new app which is called What Three Words, which is one word, strangely. What Three Words is the name of the app. Basically, the clever people in the world have decided that the globe is now divided into 3 metre by 3 metre squares, and each one has a unique three-word address allocated to it. So it's ideal for us in Hertfordshire and any other local rural brigades and emergency services to give you your exact location should you come into any trouble. So the app is called What Three Words. You will be given a three-word special unique address. You will then give that to the 999 responder you've called, and we will be able to locate you quicker and easier than in the past. What Three Words?